नमस्कार अद्वैत चिंतन सर्वेषां स्वागतम अपरोक्षानुभूति जय मनमस्ते। ओम वक्रतुंड महाकाय सूर्यकोटिसमप्रभ निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्य कृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ नमः ब्रह्माविद्यो ब्रह्मविद्यासम्प्रदायकर्तृभ्यो वंशऋषिभ्यो महद्भ्यो नमो गुरुभ्यः। पृच्छन्तु महोदय।
नमस्ते महोदय।
नमस्ते भगिनि।
नमस्ते महोदय।
नमस्ते भगिनि।
ॐ सहना भवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्तिः शान्तिः शान्तिः। श्रीहरिं परमानन्दम् उपदेष्टारं ईश्वरं व्यापकं सर्वलोकानां कारणं तं नमाम्यहम्।
धन्यवादः महोदय।
माय वीडियो इज ऑन आवर व्हाट माय वीडियो इज ऑन नो नो हेलो
Not to me. Because
okay, no, I don't know because today I joined from my mobile, so I just want to search it because I'm not able to make out whether it is on or off. Off only, no?
No, because that by default for Sanskrit 38 I kept the video off for everyone except the host.
Okay.
Even if it is on your side, it won't be on in the for the general.
Okay.
So we are into the karya karana discussions of reality of the world versus the reality of its cause and the reality of the upadana upadeya or nimitta upadeya, all type of cause and effect is being discussed. In the previous class we had discussed about vacharambanam vikaro namadeva vrittigateva satyam, that is it is only by vakalambanam, by the name dependency on the name and the form, there are multiplicity which is in reality which we are experiencing. But when you analyze it, scrutinize it properly, we will see that there is the names and forms are not real because they have a tendency to be changing, and whatever is changing is anitya, and anitya cannot be the truth. The satyatvam of the jagat, it cannot be the nama rupa, even though nama rupa is a satya while we are experiencing it because of our mind. So that in the next three to four verses, it is in being further analyzed from a different angle by Acharya as well as Vyakhyakara, so Vidyaranyamini. Vijaya Bhagini, Patati Va?
Amji. Karyakaranatta Nityam आस्ते घटमृदोर्यतां तथैव श्रुतियुक्तिभ्यां प्रपञ्च ब्रह्मनोरिह। पदच्छेदः कार्यकारणता नित्यम् आस्ते घटमृदोः यथा तथैव श्रुतियुक्तिभ्यां प्रपञ्च ब्रह्मणोः इह। अन्वयः यथा घटमृदोः कार्यकारणता नित्यमास्ते तथा एव प्रपंच ब्रह्मणोः श्रुतियुक्तिभ्याम् इह प्रतिपादिता इति अस्ति अत्र प्रतिपादनम्. अनन्तरं तत्र हेतुं सदृष्टान्तम् आह कार्ये इति तथा सौम् एकेन मृत्पिडेन सर्वं मृण्मयं विज्ञातं स्यात् इत्यादि श्रुतिः. युक्तिः तु कार्यकारणयोरन्यत्वे एककारणज्ञानात् सर्वकार्यज्ञानं न स्यात् इत्यादि तत्र सुगमम् अन्यत्. अस्तु जि, धन्यवादः.
धन्यवादः भगिनि. Here is continuing from that Mritpinda example of the mud and the pot. Karya yada ghada mridoho karya karanata nityam aste. That is a fact that the mrit and the ghada, the relationship of the cause and effect is nityam. Same way tada eva prapancha brahmanoho. Same is the situation with the prapancha which is appearing in Brahmana, Leda, Ghada is an appearance of in the mud as a name and form, Tatha, same is the case with Prapancha, the world of experience or the multiplicity which we are experiencing from the point of view of Brahmana. And Shruti Yuktim Aha Pratipadita, this is being explained in the Shruti many, many places as well as the Yukti also, Shruti itself. He is giving the yukti for the shruti yukti. Here we have to take it as that shruti yukta yukti. Shruti explained it in the logical way how it is being done is pratipadita. Tatra hetum sadrishtantam aha kajeti. Now here the drishtanta, again the same sloka from the Chandogya Upanishad is quoted. Yata saumya, just as my dear son, ekena na mritpindena sarvam mrinmayam vijnatam sad. Just as why knowing the lump of mud, everything that is mrinmayam, made out of mud, vijnatam sad, is you will know the cause and effect of the appearances of mud in different forms. Because in the example where in the sloka, the father is showing the son the different objects made out of clay, like the pot, the lamp, and the storage, the rice storage or the grain storage, etc., etc., in the which was there in his ashram. So, ekena mritpendena sarvam mrinmayam vijnatam syat ityadi shruti. That Chandogya Shruti is being quoted here. Yukti hittu karya karanayor anyatve eka karana jnanat sarva karyam jnanam na syat ityadi. See here, karya karana ajnanat sarvam. Sarkarya jnanam na syat. Okay, eka karana karana jnanat sarva karya jnanam na syat iti. Okay, that is what we have to analyze now. Now what it is saying, that karya karana yor anyatve. Now there is cause and effect. Other than the cause and effect, eka karana jnanat. Now knowing one manmayam, mrinmaya pindam, sarvam mrinmayam vijnatam sa, tadaiva eka eva brahma, sa ekaha, sa ekam vita. All those things are the way in which Brahma or the Atma is being described in the Shruti. So from that karya, karanam is the prapancham. Sa tasmat akashat atmanat sambhudaha akashat vayu vayu ragni agni rapaha adji pradibhya raushadaya aushabe vyo annam annat purushaha purushat. अन्न रसमयः इत्यादि तैत्तिरीय इज एक्सप्लेनिंग हाउ द फ्रॉम दट कॉज फ्रॉम दट ब्रह्म हाउ द आकाशादि पंचभूतानि जायन्ते एवं there is another place where Taittiriya itself is saying so akameta bahusyam prajayeti he desired to become many so in that example we have all saying that karya karana eka karana jnanat sarva karyam jnanam asyat see here we have to take our personal example if we look at the Parma example which is Shruti saying it is for information But yukti, how will you use the yukti? For using the yukti, we have to understand one thing. How do we create the multiplicity of our own dream world, which includes keeping ourselves in the dream as a part of the dream? The entire world in the dream, like whether it is it's a supernatural world or the world where the elephants can fly or in any sort of experience in the dream from where does it come so kamayata so it is a creation of that knowledge becoming many so what is called the soprakashita and the knowledge as I is also becoming part of that dream experience for us so that is why we are also available in the dream but not with this body mind and intellect or the physical body of name and form which we have in the waking these are entirely only exclusively for the waking these name form and experiences are not taken into the dream world there may be mix up of some of because of the vasana or the in the subconscious mind the impressions left by the waking which may get entangled in the experience of the dream so there may be a tint of reality which is coming from our experiences in the dream but if you look at the dream analyze it properly there is no extra substance which is created into the dream for us while we are experiencing it is all mere experiences which we call it as we experienced a elephant in the dream or we experienced cold in the dream or we were chased by a lion in the dream whatever may be the experience the experiencer we as an experiencer is also present in the dream and the experiences of the dream are the world of multiplicity just as the world in the waking is also present with a different reality there now the different reality is felt only after we wake up but at the time of dreaming what happens is that the entire world of dream is real we may feel hungry we may feel thirsty we may not get water when we are thirsty if it is a suffering dream or if it is a happy dream we may have a king like food even though we may not have had a grain for the night when we went to sleep look at even a beggar can dream to be a king in the dream but he may not have had a morsel of food for the whole day before he went to sleep but in the sleep he can dream as a king and having sumptuous meal that experience at that time while dreaming is real because he had a desire to dream to eat a food meal and that would have caused the dream to come up as his satisfaction of his desires so there may be reasons which we are not getting into the reasons right now but what here the important point is that eka karana is the reason why multiple karyas are experienced and we are ourselves in the dream as an object of experiencer in the dream while experiencing the dream we are taking part as an experiencer now same analogy in the waking world is there and we are also in this world as an experiencer So what is the difference between the dream and the waking? From the point of view of their experience, while dreaming, the entire dreams were as real as waking. While waking is as real as what it is we are having today. But that reality of the waking was not present in the dream for us to disturb the dream. Only that memory of the dream which comes toward the last part of before waking is the dream which we remember in the waking as a part of memory, because that is a ubhayasthanam. Because half we are asleep, half we were awake. So that is why we remember some part of the dream. Actually speaking, the deeper dream which we experienced in our dream, we don't even remember what was the dream. But we had a lot of experience of the dream. Before we wake up, toward the tail end, there is ubhayasthana means a mixture of two awareness, of the dream awareness as well as the waking awareness, which etches a part of it as a memory for us to wake up and say that, oh, I had a bad dream or I had a good dream, or thank God it was not real, I was chased by a lion, or whatever may be the experience we had, we say. But we know that it's not real, so we don't really worry about it. But it cannot be said when it comes to the waking, when experiences of waking cannot be denied in any other state of ours, like dream or deep sleep. The problem is because our logic and our, you know, time concept, the cause and effect of reality is only felt in the waking. So the problem is in the waking, so we need to find the solution in the waking only, as the problem is in the waking. For that purpose is what Shruti and Yukti has to be used for analyzing that. So what is the Yukti? Ekena mrutpandena sarvam mrinmayam vijnyatam chat. So just as one lump of clay can become many objects, same way, the water can take different shapes of cloud, waves, snow, and lake, river, whatever the names we want to use it, we can use it. But it's all water alone. Same way, that Brahmana from where the prapancha comes. Now prapancha, if you really look into the prapancha, what is the prapancha? Pachi Vistare is prapancha. It is that from that Pachi Vistare Dhatu, the prapancha word is coined. Same is a Brahatva Brahma. Both are the mean. That is why both the words are being used separately. The etymological meaning of both are the same. Both are showing the vastness of it. And because of the vastness is the same for the prapancha as well as Brahma, there is a chance that both are the same. Now, what is that we different, but why not we see Brahma in the prapancha, or why not we are not aware of the Brahma in the prapancha, is something which is being discussed in the following slokas by the Acharya. Before coming to that, he is taking two more examples of this one. But what happens to that prapancha is what we have to analyze it. So for that, the next sloka says, Shobha Bhagini, next sloka.
Amudaya. Grushya mane ghato yadvan mrittikayati vaibalat vikshya mane prapanchepi brahmaiva bhati bhasuram. पदच्छेदः गृह्यमाणे घटे यद्वत् मृत्तिका आयाति वै बलात् वीक्ष्यमाणे प्रपञ्चे अपि ब्रह्मा एव आभाति भासुरम्. अन्वयः यद्वत् घटे गृह्यमाणे मृत्तिका वै बलात् आयाति तथा अपि प्रपञ्चे वीक्ष्यमाणे भासुरम् ब्रह्मा एव आभाति. कार्यकारणयोः अनन्यत्वम् एव दृष्टान्तेन स्पष्टयति गृह्यमाणा इति भासुरम् प्रमाणनिरपेक्षतथैव भासनशीलम स्पष्टम अन्यत।
धन्यवाद
महोदय।
Yes, I, now I, from the continuation from the previous shloka, Brahma eva prapanjam bhati is what is the karya karana explanation given, that karya is prapancha, karanam is Brahma. So Brahma eva bhati prapancha iti vasuram is that what is to be analyzed here. So what does Anvaya says? Yadvad गडे गृह्यमाणे मृत्तिका वै बलात् आयाति, इत्युक्ते लाइक दैट गृह्यमाणे घटे व्हाट इज अपीयरिंग एज गडा बलात् चिंतयति चेत् मृत्तिका एव आयाति। इफ यू फोर्स अवरसेल्फ टू एनालाइज द अपीयरेंस ऑफ द घडा, वी आर टेकन टू the reality of the gada, what is nothing but mrit. But artakriya karityam or the utility, when we are using the gada, we are not realizing that, we are not even giving importance to that. Even though we may know it, we may not give a importance it. For our purpose, the gada has a utility for filling water or storing grains or whatever may be there. We are using that product of the mud. So what is required is here is that बलात् गृह्यमाणे मृत्तिका एव घटा इति आयाति तदा एव, दैट जस्ट एज दैट व्हेन वी गेट ए स्क्रूटनी विल रिवील दैट द पॉट इज नथिंग बट मड, तथापि सेम वे प्रपंच वीक्षमाणे भासुरं ब्रह्म एव आयाति। नाउ भासुरं ब्रह्म इज अ मेन पार्ट वी हैव टू सी। वीक्षमाणे प्रपंचे इन प्रपंच what we are experiencing, this is that bhasuratvam of what we are talking about. What we are experiencing as a world is name and form, but there is a consciousness or awareness in the every article or every atom of the prapancha which we are experiencing every moment of life. That bhasuram or the awareness which is there is the brahmasya स्वरूपता। यदा मृत इज द विच वी कैन सी इन अ घड़ा, सेम वे वी कैन सी दैट द अवेयरनेस और द कॉन्शियसनेस और द वेरी रीजन वी आर एबल टू कॉग्नाइज और एक्सपीरियंस इन अवर एवरी एक्सपीरियंस द शाइनिंग पाथ as awareness is the Brahma, which we call it as prapancha because we add the nama rupa, it just as we give the nama rupa for a ghada, even though it is made of mud. Same way, the consciousness when we are, or the awareness of every article which we are experiencing, what we are actually experiencing is the awareness or the consciousness or existence consciousness, Satchidananda, Brahma, Satya Jnanam Anandam Brahma, whatever may be the terminologies which you want to use it, you can use it for Brahma. But what happens is that even while experiencing the existence and awareness of the object, our concentration is not on the existence and awareness of the object which are coming to us as experience, but we are so engrossed in our experiential aspect of the name and form of the object or the adjectives which we give it onto the object, we hardly realize the substratum of the existence and awareness of the objects which are being coming to us. So only if we have the same way we analyze our the gadamrit example, same way we explain that the problem here, because we don't know what is Brahma. Even though Satchidanandam Brahma and Nitya Anitya Satya Jnanam Anandam Brahma, or that the both Anyaya Vetirekana Rupena, but the positive attitude and the negative attitude of Brahma is being saying told,
It is not cognizable for the mind to know what is Brahma. So, Vikshamane Vasuram Brahma is why Vaisheshika Acharya is saying very clearly. Because what happened? The Bhanatvam or the awareness, our Bodham is the Bhanam. Without Bodham, the Prapancha doesn't exist for us. So, what is Prapancha actually speaking if you really reduce it to that? It is everything is a Bodham or Bhanam or Vasuram Brahma. That Pratibodha Viditam, that every Bodham, Bodham, Prati, what we are experiencing or what we are knowing is nothing but the awareness, what is called Brahma. But since we don't know what is Brahma or reality, but that Acharya says that, that is what exactly is the reality of every object. The name and form are superimposed on that experience of awareness. When the awareness is shining on us, we are actually in contact, or we are, there is nothing but other than everything is an experience. Our own reality, our own entity, our own existence is also an awareness for us. But the moment we do the tadatmya with the deha, I am saying aham, dehatma, deha buddhi comes to me. Then all these attributions that I am drishta, srota, manda, all those activities which are not, is a separate activity, but it is all relatively superimposed activity on the knowledge. What is happening is in our experience of seeing. Seeing is also a knowledge only. But we call it as, because you see, we are using the eyes, with that experience or the knowledge or the bhanam or the bodham of seeing something, we do not give the importance to the experience of seeing, but we give importance to the object which we are seeing, and then therefore we say that I am seeing a computer, or I am seeing a mobile, or I am seeing a flower, or I am seeing something. But what happens is that in that very moment of experience, what is happening is that there are multiplicity of experiences which is called the prapancha. The prapancha includes me as an object in the prapancha. I have an existence and experience. I as an experience, I cannot deny. Because aham asmi sada bhami kata chitna aham apriya. I am an experience which I cannot deny that I am experiencing. If I am not taking, associating myself as a body, what is my reality is I am an experience. In me the experiencing happens, because if I use my body, the objects or the sense organs of the body bring, when it brings light, I call it as I am seeing it, drishta. And what is that silly when you call it as a drishta? The drishta is nothing but the experience of the objects which is coming as in the form of light. And light is what? Light is nothing but an experience. Light is not an object of independence. We are giving a name light as a light wave or other thing. But without experiencing, the light doesn't exist. And when the light is bringing the vision of an object from outside, it is what is coming to us is experience of the object. The object is separated. So these separations are all like how do we separate from the mud the pot. Same way from Brahma or the experience, everything is an experience. By the name and form, we make it separately and we call it as prapancha. So what happens is, prapanche vikshamane vasuram brahma eva abadi. So the one who has got that very method of analyzed way to go into the cause effect or the analytical strength to see the mud in a mud pot, same way if we develop our awareness or our skill of analyzing things, we will find that the entire prapancha, the name and the whole thing which is called, we call it as prapancha, the world of experience is nothing but experiences. And the name and form has no reality in that. Then the fact is that it is only a bhasaram. or a bhanam or a bodham. This is what is being where spashtayati grihyamani vidhi vasaram pramana nirapekshata tateiva bhanashilam spashta. So bhanashilam yasmin asti, the one who has that bhanashilam to see that in himself and in the rest of the prapancha, for him iti spashtayati. Drishtandera spashtam bhavati prapancha vikshamane bhasuram eva asti. So this is the aspect which is being explained in this sloka. Any questions?
Father, Bhasuram, what did he say? I didn't hear properly. Bhasuram?
Bhasuram Brahma means jolati, no? That the experience is being felt as a bhanam, bodham.
Bhanam means? What is
bhanam
that?
Means shine. It is shines as an experience, no? What is an experience? Okay. What is an experience to you?
Okay.
That whatever experience is an awareness or a light of awareness or an experience of what you call that.
Mm-hmm. It is that. Okay.
So that is, it is not a jadavastu. But that experience itself is giving a rise to knowledge. Therefore, it is a bodham. Right? The experience and knowledge are not separate.
Yes.
No, that is why bhasuram means knowledge, or bhanam, bodham, it can be used as the same meaning for it.
Okay, understood. Dhanyavad.
Okay. Right. So, Lalita Pagani, this can tell this sloka, you can see that?
Yes, I can see, yes.
Okay, you thought you were in the mobile, so I don't know, I was not sure.
Yeah, now I'm in both, because I'm in mobile and I'm finding it difficult, so I've joined in both, but okay. It's not a problem, no? Okay.
No problem, you can read it. You can read it, fine.
Okay. Yeah, I can. Tadaivatma vishuddhosti, yashuddho bhati vaisada, yathaiva dvividha rajjur jnano jnanino anisham. Yathaiva dvividha rajjur jnano ajnanino anisham. Padachedaha tadaiva atma vishuddhaha asti hi ashuddhaha bhati vai sada tataiva dvividha rajjur jnanaha ajnaninaha anisham. अन्वयः आत्मा तदैव विशुद्धः अस्ति अशुद्धः हि भाति तथैव रज्जुज्ञानः अनिशं वै ज्ञानिनः अज्ञानिनः द्विविधा भाति ननु ब्रह्मणि भासमाने प्रपञ्चो न भासते शङ्क्या आशंक्या अवस्था भेदेन उभयमपि भासत इति सदृष्टान्तमाह सदैवे इति तत्र ज्ञानिनः सदैवात्मा विशुद्धः अज्ञान सत्कार्य प्रपञ्चमलरहितत्वात् निष्प्रपञ्चो अस्ति अज्ञानिनस्तु सदैव अशुद्ध अस्ति इति ब्रह्मात् विभाति वै इति तत् प्रसिद्धौ उभयत्रापि दृष्टान्तः यथा रज्जुज्ञानिनः सर्पा भावतया निर्विषत्वेन अभयंकरी अज्ञानिनस्तु सर्परूपतया विपरीतत्वेन भयंकरीति द्विविधा भाति अयं भावः ब्रह्म यद्यपि स्वयं प्रकाशत्वेन सदा भाति एव तथापि वृत्ति आरूढत्वेन वृत्ति आरूढत्वेन पुरुषार्थ उपयोगी इति उपयोगः इति ज्ञानिनः प्रतिभाति न अज्ञानिनः सूर्यदीपादि इव चक्षुष मंदरोरिति दिक्
चक्षुष्मन्दयोरिति
मन्दयोरिति दिक् दिक्
दिक्
दिक् दिक्
धन्यवाद भगिनी
धन्यवाद
सदैवात्मो विशुद्धोऽस्ति ह्यशुद्धो भावि वै सदा यदैव द्विविधा रज्जुर्ज्ञानो अज्ञानिनोरनिशम् अन्वयः आत्मा सदैव विशुद्धः अस्ति नौ दिस् इस् वाट्स् वन् थिङ्ग् यु हव् टु आल्वेस् अण्डर्स्टाण्ड् दट् सदैव विशुद्धः आत्मा नित्यः शुद्धः नित्यशुद्धगुप्त स्वभावतः सो आत्मा सदैव सो नित्य सदैव इत्युक्त्वा नित्य आज्ञ विशुद्धः सो नित्यशुद्धः अस्ति अशुद्धा हि भाति as if it is appears as if ashuddha for ajnaninah tadaiva rajujnanah anisham vai jnaninah ajnaninah dvidha bhati same way the knowledge of sarpa the raju for the jnani it is always raju only for ajnanina it is appearing to be different so the vastu ekameva rajju jnana for the jnani it is rajju for the ajnani it is appearance of what you call snake is very much real but when the ajnana is gone the same big person becomes a jnani therefore for him it becomes a rajju that rajju jnana satyameva bhavati But as long as that ajnana is residing in the person, anisham dvividha bhavi, always that appearance will be there. What does it mean? Sadeva vishuddha brahma, atma brahma, sadeva vishuddha asti. The experience has no taint of any qualities. There is nothing called good, bad, ugly, heat, cold, all the duality which we are seeing in the prapancha, that is not there in any experience. If you look into the reality, the Rajujnana, same way, if we look at the Atma or Brahma, which is saying that Vasuram Brahma, same way, the knowledge which we are getting out of the prapancha, the different objects of the prapancha, the Nama Rupa, the experience of everything is purely experience without any adjectives qualities of that even the good and the bad if you don't have the attitude towards good and bad both of them are just experiences in its own nature the moment we add our mental likes and dislikes then we add color to the experience saying it's a good it is bad But if you look at it that way, if you look at without that, you know, visheshanam, experience is shuddha, sarvada. Always experience, all experiences are in pure experience only. We don't have that adjectives in any experience. So, atma sadeva shuddha asti. Ashuddha ivi hi vadi. Ashuddha Iva Vadi. Tatra he is like Iva. Why? Ajnaninaha. Ajnanatvena. When we don't have that Shila, what you call that Shilam of Bhana Shilatvam, if we don't have that habit of looking at the reality as a reality, but go by the appearance of the objects, then what happens is, that is becoming ashuddha because we are going by the name and form and the qualities adjectives on the objects so vastu is in reality ekameva the fire is fire only it will have the heat as a as a swabhava. But that heat becomes wanted or unwanted depending upon our mental conditions. In summer, we don't want the heat, but at the same time, in the winter, we need the heat to keep us warm. So, like and dislike depends upon our mental conditions. But fire does not change its habit. Fire remains fire, always giving heat, whether we like it or not. Same way, every object is in reality, if we analyze it, they all have the same habit all the time. Sada eva. Na prakrute ranyado bhavo kadanchit bhavishyati. That this sloka says in Mandukya Karika. Prakriti, the nature, anyatha bhava, it doesn't show that at another form. Katanchit na bhavishyati. It never can have, that fire can never be not fire. It is always fire and heat producing. Heat and light is the swabhava of the fire. Can that fire ever be not fire without light and heat? No. So, prakrute ranyada bhava katanchit na bhavishyati. So, same is the case with every object in the world. They are all always the same. Whether we like it or not, we dislike or we hate it, we want it to aggrandize or we don't want to aggrandize, or whatever may be the situation, the objects of the world is always having the same swabhava. Because of that, sada visuddha. And that is because they always give the same experience to a person who is the same fire. One person may like, one person may not like it. But in the presence of the same fire, one may like it, one may dislike it. If the swabhava doesn't change for the fire, the like and dislike is in the one who is looking at with a different, not seeing the shuddhatvam of the prakriti of the fire, but the ashuddhatvam because of the ajnana in the residing in that one who is experiencing it. The one who likes it also is ashuddhi, the one who dislikes it also has got ashuddha, but the jnani who is in between, he knows the nature of the fire is to light and heat. So he is not either attracted towards fire, not repulsed by fire. He accepts fire as fire without like and dislike. So, but and for that we need jnana. Same way, what example is given is rajut jnana anisham. Anisham means sarvada. Always rajut jnana is rajut jnana only. But for a jnani, it is a rope all the time. For an ajnani, it appears to be a snake sometimes. The rope has never become a snake. Even before becoming the snake, the rope was rope. Even while seeing the snake on the rope was rope only. Even when the knowledge of snake was a bhranti or a delusion is known by the person who sees a snake on the rope, is removed the vision of the snake which was not the rope only was existing even after the experience also. So before, while and after all the training time, the experience of the rope has not undergone through any change. For the jnani, he knows that this is an experience of the rope. He accepts that as a reality. For him, the rope is the reality all the three times. For the ajnani, who do not see the reality, for him, the snake is a reality, unless and then the jnana comes, that the reality is snake, is rope. Same way, the Vishuddha Brahma Prapancha Rupena Bhavi, Basuram Brahma. What is we are experiencing in the world of objects is nothing but experience of things as it is. Why prakriti has got, it will be never changing. But because of the ignorance that we don't know that we are having the contact with an object is nothing but an experience, and the experience does not change. It is always the same. We are the one who is giving a snake look, like making it like and dislike. I don't like the snake because and I got the fear and I felt the rope is a snake and I got a fear. Same way, the fire I don't like at that time the fire is a one which is having a dislike. I am having a dislike for the fire. If I have a liking for the fire or the heat in the winter, I like the fire. So the fire did not change anything. Tada visuddha asti. But ajnanatvena, because we feel that, you know, I need fire or I don't need fire, or I don't heat or I don't need heat, we are all creating all these differences in the opinion. Nanu brahmane basamane prapancho na basate pyashanka avastha vedena ubhayam iti basata iti sadrishtanta maha sadeiva iti. So the drishtanta ubhayatvam is shown. That rope itself is becoming the snake. Even though in reality there is no snake, for the jnani the rope is the avastha, for the ajnani the avastha is of the snake. Tatra jnanina sadeva atma visuddha. For the jnani, the prapancha which is Brahma Vasuram, sadatman sarvatman, sadeva atma visuddha. It is sada. Always it is the pure awareness, experience or consciousness without any adulteration or any adjectiveness. Ajnana tatkaryam karya prapancha malarahitatvat nishpanna prapanchosti. Ajnana tatkarya prapancha malarahitatvat. Because prapancha malarahitatvat, prapancha malam is because of ajnana karya. So ajnana karyatvena prapancham malam bhavati, jnanatvena tasya rahitam tasya malarahitatvam bhavati, nishprapancha api asti. Prapancham becomes nishprapancham by, because prapancha is no more prapancha, but it is become vishuddha atma sarvatma. So sarvam khaluvidam brahma, when we say, that is what it is. It is indicated that sadatmana sarvam atmaiva bhut. Everything becomes a pure lump of experiences, and it is a light of experience which we call it as prapancha. And it is malarahita because we don't have the likes and dislikes. And likes and dislikes are ajnana karya, because we go by the name and form. So ajnana karyatvena prapancham malam bhavati. Jnanatvena tasya rahitatvat nishprapanchovi bhavati. Prapancha also becomes not a separate prapancha. Prapancham, which we call it as a name and form, that is where the prapancha, the name and form, dissolves, becoming pure state of sarvatma visuddha, that pure experiences. Ajnaninastu sadaiva ashuddho asti brahmadi brahma dviva pramadvi Bhadi, Pramadvivad, Pramadi Vad Bhadi. That spelling is there. So, for the Ajnani, Sadaiva Ashuddha Asti. The Prapancha is always a reality in the name and form for the Ajnani. And because of the Brahma, it is Ashuddha Iva Bhadi. Tat Prasiddho Ubayamadi Ubayatra Avi Drishtandam Yathahi Rajju Ajnanina. Sarpa bhavataya nirvishayatve abhayankari ajnaninastu sarpa rupata vibharitatvena bhayankari iti. So the drishtantam is being explained. Raju jnaninaha sarpa bhavataya, sarpa abhavataya. So for the jnani there is no sarpa bhava in the raju. So nirvishayatvena abhayankari, it is not bhayam or anymore, it doesn't care. Nirvishayatvam means the vishayatva of the sarpa is not there for the jnanina. Therefore it is not bhayankari, it is abhayam. It doesn't cause a fear. Ajnaninastu, for the ajnani, sarparupadaya viviridatvena bhayankari iti dvidabhati. For the ajnani, because the snake rupa, sarpa rupa daya, because he is not seeing the jnana sarupa of the raju jnana, for him the sarpa rupa daya viviridatvena, because it is not, why viviritam? Here the word vivirita has got a very important meaning, is that because raju is a jada vastu, which doesn't have life or anything. It is an inanimate, non-offensive, non-attacking a shape of a rope. In that, viviridatvena, because the ajnana, the inert rope becomes a live snake, and because the live snake is appearing for the ajnani, bhayankari bhavati, it creates bhayam. Because he is afraid of the snake, so snake, he gets on a inert, inactive object. Because of the ignorance, he creates a life, and the fear out of that is that, therefore, for the jnani, there is no fear. For the ajnani, it's always the fear, because even though vastuta, the substratum is only one. That one itself is a dhruvidabhadi. That is why Brahma and Prapancha are separate. So, Brahma Satyam Jagan Nitya Jivo Brahma Ivanapara, when Shankara says that, it is keeping in this mind. Brahma Satyam. The Satyatvam is the Raju, the Raju is the Satyam, Sarpam is Mithya. Same way, Brahma Satyam, Jagat Mithya. The Jagat or the Prapancha, what we call Nama Rupatvam, we do not see the Brahma as Prapancha or the Prapancha as Brahma. Therefore, we have a Prapancha which is separate from Brahma, and we go by the Ajnana Buddhi that Prapancha is an entity which has got adjectives, and therefore, we have the problems of life in our day-to-day experience, the likes and dislikes, because we don't see the object without any in its reality. We see the snake in the rope, same way, the heat is seen as something which is desired, and snake is, the fire is desired as undesirable. For the same fire, the two activities are superimposed on that. One person desires it, the other person doesn't desire it. But the fire has not gone through any change of its natural substance. Same way, everything in the prapancha is dhana matram, is a pure experience only. We make it as good, bad, ugly, like, dislike and all those things because of we think that name and form of the prapancha is the reality. We forget the experience which is coming unadulterated as a pure Vishuddha, Brahma, Bhanam. That we do not act, we do not acknowledge, we do not know about it. When we do not know, we take it reality that the experience of the world is in multitude. The multitude is a superimposition on the same substratum of the knowledge or the experience of things by the adjective of the name and form and the experience which we desire to get it from there or we do not desire to get it from there. So from that point, it is Dvivida Bhati. Ayam Bhavaha Brahma Yadyadi Swayam Prakashatvena Sada Bhatyevi Tadapi Vritti Arudatvena Purushartha Upayogi Iti Jnaninaha Pratibhati Ajnaninaha Na Ajnaninaha. So what it is that is ayam bhavaha, this experience or this status, Brahma yadyadi swayam prakashatvena sada bhati eva. Brahma, what we call it as Brahma, is nothing but existence and awareness or consciousness, satchit. Sada bhati swayam prakashatvena. It is that swayam prakasha means it that for the world to be an experiencing, we don't need an additional thing for us to be aware of the world. The world itself is coming to us as an experience, existence and experience all the time. Sarvada. So, yati, so that is the word that the terminology Swayam Prakashatvena, because to experience, we don't need anything outside to make us experience it. Any object in the world, it has got that power to make us experience that without the help of anything other than that. So that is what is called the suprakashatvam. So if you want to know, now the example which is that Surya Deepa Pivi Riva Chakshumandayo Riva Iti Dik. So the example which is that Surya Deepa. Suryasya Anya Deepasya Anya Deepecha. When two lights are kept side by side, can we say that one light is showing the other, another light, or the other light is showing this light? No. Both lights have got independent suprakashata. This is a gross form. But if we look at everything in the world as a prapanchatvam, every object is exhibiting or emitting pure existence and awareness, which is our actual experience, without the name and form and the adjectives. Every object, every moment, bodham, bodham, prati. What is life itself is a continuity of, you know, that is why tadabhi vritya arudatvena purushartha upayogi iti jnaninaha. Because of the vritti of the mind, vritti arudatvena, therefore what I am saying, we are saying the purushartha yogi upayogi. Because of purushartha artha dharma artha kama moksha. For that, the Brahma, there is actually speaking there, dharmartha kama moksha is because of the ajnana level. Because what is that? Because we think that world is separate and we need to have artha, kama, moksha and all those things. But actually speaking, if you look into that, if you remove the vritti of that prapancha has got a reality independent from Brahma, if that knowledge is not going to confuse you or confuse us from the independent reality of the world, then purushartha itself is nullified. Because there is very, for whom is the purushartha? Aham Brahmasmi, or I am the Brahma, and prapancha is also sarvam kalidam Brahma. So prapancha is Brahma, aham Brahma. So for whom is the purushartha? Artha dharma artha kama moksha. That only a jnani, when he realizes, he will realize that. Till then, these are all valid. Dharma artha kama moksha is valid because it is vrityarudatvena. Same way, pratibhadi na ajnaninaha. Therefore, an ajnani who has not realized this vision of seeing Brahma in Sarva or Sarvatma Bhava, Aham Brahmasmi, Sarvam Kalidam Brahma, Brahma Satyam Jagan Mitya, Jivo Brahma Ivanavara, any amount of words which you can quote from the Sruti. But that, if it doesn't shine on the individual, Sajnani, Chakshumandayo Riva, for him, even the eyes is there, the eyes are able to see that, because of the darkness, he doesn't see the light. He says, I don't see a light, but his eyes is showing the darkness. We are not able to say that I am seeing darkness, but we say, I know, I see nothing. That is the confusion we have. When we are in the darkness, what's our normal reaction? Oh, it's pitch dark, I don't see anything. But do we ever say that, no, I know nothing, I see darkness? We don't say that. Why? Because that is, we don't take it as an object which we are seeing. The I can see darkness is not accepted by us. But we always want something to be seen by the I. That is the ajnanatvam. So in same way, we always want to see the world as a prapancha with the nama, rupa and the qualities. We don't want to see the reality of experience, existence and experience in the real world of the prapancha. To know that is the reality, and therefore, everything which is assumed by me as a vrityaruda, by the mind, vritti, manovritti, arudatvena, you know, that dvandva, all the dvandva, siroshna, suga, dukkha. So dvandva vimukta astu, if we are removing from the dvandva, then only you can see the prapancha, as bhaswaram brahma. Till then, we will not be able to see the satyatvam in the whole reality of experience. We'll stop here. Any questions?
No, ji.
No, Mahadeya.
No, Mahadeya.
Okay.
नो महोदय महोदय तत्र चक्षुस मत अंधा इति अस्ति इति मने
ओके देयर आर सम स्पेलिंग मिस्टेक्स व्हिच आई नीड टू करेक्ट इट आई विल डू दैट धन्यवाद
तत्र चक्षु न किमर्थम उक्तवती इत्युक्ते सीइंग फर्निश्ड विथ आईस इति अस्ति तत्र चक्षुस मत अंध इति भिन्नः अर्थः भवति इति धन्यवाद
ओम पूर्णमद पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते ओम शांति 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 हरि ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः हरि ओम धन्यवाद नमस्कार